So we are going to discuss refraction and prism concept. So in ray optics topic. So what is the main topic? Ray optics is the main topic. In that one, we are going to discuss refraction as well as prism. Now, first one, we are going to discuss a basic topic, that is a refraction. So what is meant by refraction? So when a light ray incident on a surface that is separating two transparent media, then its direction is going to change. So what is the refraction? When a light ray that is incident on a medium, that is incident on a surface that is separating two transparent media, then the direction of the light ray changes, then that property, this property is called refraction. So what is meant by refraction? When a light ray incident on a surface that is separating two different transparent media, then the direction of light ray is going to change. That is called, that phenomena is called refraction. Now, so assume that here two mediums are there. One is a rarer medium, other one is a denser medium. So what is meant by rarer medium and what is meant by denser medium? So denser medium means a refractive index of that one is more compared to the other medium. If you compare these two mediums, for this one refractive index is more, then we can call it as a denser medium. For this one, if refractive index is less compared to this one, then it is called as a rarer medium. So rarer medium and denser medium means, so if you compare any two medium, so in that one is denser means refractive index of that one is more compared to the other one. Next, so go through this one. So here light ray that is incident on media, that is a surface that is separating two different media. So this is the surface that is separating these two mediums. So this is the surface, this blue line is the surface that is separating these two mediums. This blue line is the surface that is separating these two lines. Now draw a normal to this one. Draw a normal to this one, normal to first surface as well as a second surface like this. So this is a normal. Normal drawn to that surface is the one. Now, so a light ray incident on the surface like this. So light ray is going to incident on this surface that is separating two different media. Now, assume that that is making an angle theta 1 with the normal. So what is the angle here? Theta 1 is the angle with the normal. Now, after refraction, that means once it is enter into the other medium, then angle is equal to, let it be theta. Assume that angle is theta 2. Angle is theta 2. Now, so here, light enter into the first medium, that is making an angle theta 1 with the normal drawn at the surface. Next, similar to this one, in other medium, that is making an angle theta 2 with the normal. Now, direction of the light ray is shown with the arrow mark. Direction of the light ray shown with this arrow mark. Now, for this one, can you write the equation? Can you write the equation for this? That is from Snell's law. So, from Snell's law, we can write equation for this one. So, what is Snell's law? So, from Snell's law, we can write equation as this one. N1 sin I. N1 sin I is equal to N2 sin R. So R, we can write that one as for previous case, we can write the same equation as now for this one, if you apply Snell's law, what is the first medium refractive index is given as N1. refractive index is given as n1 for this one. For this one, refractive index is n1. For this one, refractive index is n2. Now, can you apply Snell's law for this one? We can write by using Snell's law, we can write n1 sine. What is the angle in this medium? Theta 1. And n2, what is the angle in the second medium? Sine theta 2. We need to write Snell's law equation like this. Here angles where we need to take, so with normal drawn at the surface only we need to take angles, not here. This is the wrong one. So always we need to take angles with respect to the normal only. So if you apply Snell's law to the surface, then we can write n1 sin theta 1 equal to n2 sin theta 2. Refractive index of the medium, angle in that medium. This one, refractive index of the second medium, angle in the second medium. So you have to write Snell's law like this for this one. Next, so go through the next one. So if you apply Snell's law for a surface that is drawn like this. So this is a refractive, that is a surface that is separating two different media. Here, first medium is N1, this medium is N2. So assume that this is one medium, this is the other medium, another medium. Now, normal drawn for this surface that is separating medium is this one. Assume that a light ray enter into this first medium. This is making an angle I with this one. Now, after refraction, this is making an angle R. Now, to apply Snell's law for this diagram, what we need to write? N1 sin I equal to N2 sin R. What is N1? N1, N2 are the refractive index of the two different media. Next, what is I and what is R? I is called angle of incidence or angle in first medium, and R is called angle of refraction or angle in second medium. Sometimes they may give theta 1, theta 2 here. So if they give theta 1, theta 2, then we need to write N1 sin theta 1 equal to N2 sin theta 2. Like that you have to write. This is the basic equation for Snell's law of refraction. We can use this one when there is a refraction. If there is a refraction, then use Snell's law. Now, so here, what is N1? N1 can be written as N1 is the refractive index of the medium, first medium. N2 is the refractive index of the second medium. So N1 can be written as C by V1, and N2 equal to C by V2. Refractive index again can be written as speed of light by velocity in that medium. Next, N1 can be written as C by V1. What is C? C is a speed of light. What is V1? Velocity in that medium, first medium. So we can write N1, N2 as a like this. N1 equal to C by V2. V1, N2 equal to C by V2. So what is the refractive index formula? That is also called absolute refractive index. N equal to C by V. What is C? C is the speed of light. What is V? That is speed of light in that particular medium. Next one. So if you take a ratio between N1 and N2, we can write N2 by N1 as N2 by N1 equal to, what is the formula for N2? C by V2. What is the formula for N1? C by V1. So cancel C, then you will get V1 by V2. Cancel C, then you will get V1 by V2. So this is the ratio of refractive index, or V equal to F lambda. So velocity or speed of light or speed of sound wave formula is V equal to F lambda. Can I write speed in terms of frequency and wavelength? This is the equation for that one. So velocity of light wave or velocity of sound wave, we can write in terms of frequency and wavelength as V equal to F lambda. Substitute that one. So here F into lambda 1 by F into lambda 2. Why I am taking only F? when it is traveling. So here is the important point. So that is why I am taking F instead of F1, F2, because frequency is same when it is passing through one medium to other medium. So what is constant? When a light wave travels from one medium to other medium, frequency should be constant. So that is the important point. So here, which one is constant? When a light wave travels from one medium to other medium, frequency should be constant. What are the variables? Frequency is constant. So velocity may change, wavelength may change. Wavelength and velocity are going to change, but frequency is constant. When a light ray travels from one medium to other medium, which one is constant? Frequency is constant. Which one is going to change? Velocity and wavelength are going to change. Velocity and wavelength are going to change. So these are the important points. Now, so we can write this one as lambda 1 by lambda 2. Now, frequency, refractive index, what is the final conclusion? N2 by N1 equal to V1 by V2 or lambda 1 by lambda 2. So this is the equation we can use for numericals. So refractive index ratio is same as velocity ratio or wavelength ratio. Refractive index is same as wavelength and velocity ratio. So refractive index is inversely proportional to the speed of light in that medium. That is from this equation. So N equal to C by V. Refractive index is inversely proportional to speed of light in that medium. And inversely proportional to wavelength also. Inversely proportional to wavelength also. That means wavelength, refractive index is depends on wavelength. So that refractive index different for different colors. Different for different colors. Because the refractive index is depends on wavelength. So that we can conclude that refractive index is different for different colors. So what is the important point? Frequency does not change, but velocity and wavelength are wavelength will change. So already we discussed frequency is constant when a light ray travels from one medium to other medium. When a light ray travels from one medium to other medium, frequency is a constant. Next one. So go through the next example. So if N2 is less than N1, here is the refractive second medium of refractive index N2. Here, first medium of refractive index N1. A light ray that is enter into the first medium, after that is passing through the second medium. Now, what is the condition given? N2 is less than N1. Refractive index of second medium is less than refractive index of the first medium. So that the second medium is called rarer medium. Rarer medium. This is a denser medium. When a light ray travel from denser medium to rarer medium, then what happens after refraction? The light ray bends towards the normal. What is the original direction? This is the original direction. But light ray after refraction, light ray that shifted towards the normal. That is the main concept when a light ray travel from denser medium to rarer medium. When a light ray, what is the note? What is the important note here? When a light ray travel from denser medium to rarer medium, then what happens? The ray bends towards the normal as shown in the diagram. So instead of moving like this, that will refract like this. So what is the conclusion here? When a light ray travel from denser medium to rarer medium, what happens? The light ray bends towards the normal. Next one. Next example. Similar to this one. When a light ray travels from rarer to denser. When a light ray travels from rarer to denser in reverse way. Then what happens? The light ray moves away from the normal. Or bends away from the normal. So what is the conclusion here? When a light ray travels from rarer medium to denser medium. What happens? It bends away from the normal. So remember that conclusion, when a light ray travels from denser to rarer, that means in previous case, denser to rarer medium, what happens? light ray bends towards the normal. Next one, when a light ray travel from rarer medium to denser medium, then what happens? That light ray bends away from the normal. So these are the two conclusions. Next one. So refraction of a light ray through a prism. Refraction of a light ray through a prism. Now, so what is meant by prism? So what is meant by prism? So what is a basic definition for prism? So what is nothing but a prism? So just go through this one. What is prism? So that is a transparent medium bounded by refracting surfaces such that incident light ray and emergent light ray are in that plane and non-parallel. So what is prism? That is a transparent medium. Transparent medium only with two different surfaces. So with minimum of two different refracting surfaces. Now light ray that is passing through the prism. So incident ray, incident light ray and emergent light ray should not be parallel. That is nothing but a prism. If any medium is like this, then we can call it as a prism. Now, what is the basic diagram for prism? So this is the basic diagram for a prism. Prism will be like this. Next. Now, so coming to the prism concept, just go to this one once. First one, this I am going to derive basic equations first. After that, we can go through the formulas. First, you need to know what is I, what is R like that, what is A. So now we need to discuss that one first. Go through this one. So here, so ABC represents, ABC represents a prism. ABC represents a prism. This one. Assume that diagram for prism is like this. ABC is a prism. Now, so we need to draw two normals to this prism. We need to draw two normals to this prism. So one is on surface AB that is represented with a green line. So what is the first normal here on surface AB that is represented with line green? That is represented with NL or LN. Next, second normal we need to draw on this one, on this surface, other surface, that is nothing but that is represented by letter MN. MN is the second normal drawn on the second surface. What is LN? LN is the first normal that is drawn on the first surface. Now, when a light ray incident on the surface, first surface, that is called incident light. Incident ray. When a light ray that is incident on the first surface is called incident light ray. Next one. This one, the light ray that is coming from this prism is called emergent light ray. This one is called incident. This one is called emergent. So meaning of emergent means that is coming out from one surface. So this is called emergent ray. This one is called incident ray. Now, so here when a light incident on the surface, what happens? There is a refraction, so that direction will change. So direction will change. That is based on the refractive index. Now, so direction will change. Assume that this is making incident ray making an angle I with the normal drawn at the surface. This is called incident angle. I is called angle of incidence or incident angle. What is I? Incident. I represents incident angle. Next one. When it is refracted through a first surface, the angle at that location is represented with R1. Angle at that surface is represented with R1. What is R1? Refraction. Angle of refraction. Now, yet second surface angle is R2. Second surface angle is R2. R1, R2 are the refraction angles within the prism. Next one. That is making an angle E with a second normal. When it is emerging out from the prism, that is making an angle E with the second surface. Now that E is called emergent angle. E is emergent angle. I represents incident angle. I is incident. E is emergent angle. R1, R2 are the refraction angles within the prism. And capital A. And capital A is called angle of the prism. Angle of the prism is represented with letter capital A. Angle of the prism is nearly around 60 degrees in general. In general, for a normal prism, angle of the prism is around 60 degrees. These are the variables you have to remember. So what are the variables here? We discussed it. R1, R2 are the refraction angles within the prism. I is a incident angle. E is a emergent angle. A is a angle of the prism. These are the variables. Now, next one. So this is the derivation. Derivation I will explain after the basic explanation. Now, so here, when a light ray that is refracting from a prism, then what are the basic relations? That means if you remember these relations, then you can answer easily. You can answer the questions based on prism easily. Now, what are the relations? What are the relation between different angles? Now, first relation is angle of the prism is equal to sum of the angle of refractions. That means A equal to R1 plus R2. So angle of the prism A equal to R1 plus R2. This is the first relation for prism. So this is valid for any prism. So what is A? A equal to R1 plus R2. What is A? That is called angle of the prism. A is angle of the prism. Next one. So angle of incidence plus angle of emergent is equal to A plus delta. What is delta there? What is delta? So this is assume that this is the incident light ray. So what is the original direction? This is the original direction. But that is coming out from this one with this direction. So here the light ray entering into this one. What is the original direction of the light ray? This one represents original direction. But light ray is after refraction, light ray is coming out of the prism in this direction. So that this angle between original direction and angle between emergent ray and original direction is called deviation angle. How much that is deviated? That is denoted by deviation angle. What is meant by deviation angle? That is the angle between original direction and emergent ray. That is called a deviation angle. So deviation means in that one only meaning is there. That is called angle of deviation or deviation angle. So angle of deviation means that is the angle between original direction and emergent direction. So that is delta. That is denoted by delta. What is delta here? Delta is called angle of deviation. Angle of deviation. Delta is called angle of deviation. Now, what is the first relation? A equal to R1 plus R2. You have to remember this one. Next, I plus E equal to A plus delta. What is A? Angle of prism. Delta is a deviation angle. Now, from this one, if you want to write a deviation angle equation as I equal to E minus E, I delta equal to I plus E minus A. I plus E minus A is the angle of deviation. From this equation we can write. So that this we can derive from this diagram also. Angle of deviation is nothing but I plus E minus A. So that is from second equation only. Now, next one. Just apply Snell's law to this first surface. Apply Snell's law to this surface. Now what happens? Mu is the refractive index of this one. A refractive index of air is equal to 1. Refractive index of air n1 equal to 1. So here mu, that is n2 equal to mu. Now apply Snell's law for this surface. What happens? N1 sin I equal to n2 sine, what is the angle in second medium R1? Can I write Snell's law for this one like this? N1 sine I, what is the angle in that medium? I. So N1 sine I equal to N2 sine, what is the angle R1 here? Now substitute N1 and N2 values. N1 is 1, so sine I. N2 is mu equal to sine R1. From this equation, we can write mu as sine I by sine R1. From this one, mu equal to sine I by sine R1. What is the value of mu? Sine I by sine R1 is the value of mu. Sine I by sine R1 is the value of refractive index mu. Value of refractive index mu is sine I by sine R1. Next one. If you apply Snell's law at this surface, what happens? Just apply Snell's law here. So now just take N1 as this one, N2 equal to 1. Now, so N1 sine, what is the angle in this medium? R2 equal to N2 sine E. Just I am taking this angle and this angle, because I am applying Snell's law at this surface. Now N1 is how much? Mu sine R2 equal to N2 is how much? 1 sine E. Now from this one, 1 by mu can be written as 1 by mu equal to sine R2 by sine E. Sine R2 by sine E. That only we wrote here. So these are the formulas for prism. If prism is there, what is the basic condition? A equal to R1 plus R2. And in terms of deviation angle, I plus E equal to A plus delta. I plus E equal to A plus delta. Next, if you apply Snell's law at this surface, then what happens? Mu equal to sine I by sine R1. Mu equal to sine I by sine R1. If you apply Snell's law at this surface, then what you will get? 1 by mu equal to sine R2 by sine E. So first remember these two formulas. From Snell's law, you can solve these two formulas easily. But you have to remember these two. Next one. So deviation through small prism, thin prism. Thin prism means angle A is very less. Angle of the prism A is very less. That is nothing but a thin prism. For a thin prism, deviation angle formula is angle of deviation or deviation angle formula is given by delta equal to mu minus 1 into A. Delta equal to mu minus 1 into A. So what is mu there? That is the ratio of refractive indexes. Mu is nothing but a ratio of refractive index. Now, for a thin prism, what is the deviation angle? Delta means deviation angle. What is the value of deviation angle? Mu minus 1 into A. That means mu is different for different colors. Mu refractive index for red light is less than refractive index of violet light. Refractive index of red one is less than refractive index of violet. So if you apply this condition here, then you will get deviation angle for red is less than deviation angle for violet. Next one. Refractive index of a flint glass is more compared to the refractive index of crown glass. So that deviation for flint glass is more compared to the deviation for a crown glass. So just remember these two. Refractive index of red is less than refractive index of violet. So what is the reason? From where we got that one? Refractive index formula is C by V. Na? If velocity is more, refractive index is less. If velocity is more, refractive index is less. So from that one also we can solve. For red one, velocity is more. So that you will get a less refractive index compared to the other one. What is the formula here? For thin prism, delta equal to mu minus 1 into A. Mu minus 1 into A. So most important one in this topic, that is a minimum deviation. So first priority in this prism topic is a minimum deviation concept. So this is easy only. So based on the direct formulas, you can solve any type of problem. Now, so minimum deviation. So when you will get minimum deviation? So in minimum deviation, conditions are there. What is the first condition? Angle of incident should be, angle of incident should be equal to angle of emergent. Minimum, at minimum deviation, I equal to E. Angle of incident should be equal to angle of emergent. I should be equal to E. That is the first condition for minimum deviation. Now, if I equal to E, then what happens? R1 equal to R2 equal to R. Because here, R1 and R2 are equal in the case of minimum deviation. So, to get a minimum deviation in the case of prism, what are the conditions? I should be equal to E. What is the other condition? R1 equal to R2. I equal to E and R1 equal to R2. These are the main conditions for a minimum deviation. Now, check this diagram once. So, assume that a light ray that is incident on first surface, after that refracted and that is passing through the prism. So, at second surface, that is going to refract like this. Now, so here, I'll just check the diagram once. From this diagram, any conclusion is there? How is the light ray within the prism? This light ray within the prism is parallel to the base. The light ray within the prism is parallel to the base. That is the conclusion. So at minimum deviation condition, the light ray that is passing through the prism is parallel to the base of the prism. Parallel to the base of the prism. That is the first condition. Next one. Now, so what we get in previous case, that is in minimum deviation condition, what about I1 and I and E, I equal to E na? Next one, what is the other condition? R1 equal to R2 equal to R. These are the two conditions. These are the two conditions for a minimum deviation. Now, just substitute these conditions in basic, that is basic prism formulas. So what is the A formula? Prism in prism, R1 plus R2 na? What is the formula for A? A equal to R1 plus R2. Just substitute this one here. If R1 and R2 are same, we can write it as R plus R, 2R. A equal to 2R. Now from this one, R equal to A by 2. R equal to A by 2. Is this clear or not? Next one. What is the other equation is there? That is for prism in first previous first case. So prism case. What are the other equations? A equal to R1 plus R2. Na? What is the next equation? I plus E equal to A plus delta. I plus E equal to A plus delta. Use that equation. Na? Use that equation. Na? I plus E. I plus E equal to A plus delta. I plus E equal to A plus delta. Now, just substitute values in this one. What is the value of E? I and E are same. Na? I equal to E. Na? So that I plus I. Can I write E as I plus I equal to A plus delta. 2I equal to A plus delta. I equal to A plus delta by 2. So this is the other equation for angle of incidence. In the case of minimum deviation only. Minimum deviation means you have to follow either these two equations or these two equations. Either one. So either these two or these two. Valid for minimum deviation condition. All these are valid for a minimum deviation condition. Now, so if you substitute in Snell's law equation, then you will get a, what is the formula from Snell's law? Mu equal to sin I by sin R. If you apply Snell's law for first surface, then you will get a mu equal to sin I by sin R. What is the value of R? R equal to A by 2 na? So mu equal to sin I by sin a by 2 is one formula. Next, what is I? I equal to a plus delta by 2 na? So that this is also other equation. Mu equal to sin a plus delta by 2 by sin a by 2. This is the most important formula in this prism case. So these are the most important formulas. What are they? For minimum deviation condition, R1 equal to R2 equal to R. That is the first one. Next, I equal to E. That is the second one. Next, I equal to A plus D by 2 or delta by 2. Third formula, R equal to A by 2. Fourth formula. Next, fifth formula is mu equal to sin I by sin A by 2. Fifth one, this is the sixth one. Mu equal to sin A plus delta by 2 by A by 2. Just substitute I value here, then you will get this one. I value and R value here, then you will get this one. So these are the formulas. For minimum deviation, you should remember these formulas. What is the first one? R1 equal to R2 equal to R. What is the first one? R1 equal to R2 equal to R. First equation is I equal to E and R1 equal to R2 equal to R. You have to remember that one. Next equation, R equal to A by 2. Next one, I equal to A plus delta by 2. Next, mu equal to sin I by sin R. So we can write mu as sin I by sin R. Just substitute R value from this one, then you will get this equation. Substitute I value and R value here, then you will get this equation. So these are the formulas, most important formulas in the case of prism, these only. So first priority in this topic, minimum deviation condition only. These, based on these formulas, you have to solve the problems. So these are the first priority in this prism formula, prism case. These are the first priority problems, formulas. Next one. So in minimum deviation condition, graph will be like this. So graph will be like this. So at a particular value, so delta is a minimum, that is called angle of incidence. So at a particular angle of incidence, delta is minimum. So graph for that one is like this. Next one, maximum deviation. Next condition, so this is less priority compared to the previous topic. So first priority is a minimum deviation condition only. What is the first priority topic in this one? Minimum deviation condition is the first priority. Next priority, this is the less priority compared to the previous one. And who is already in the end? Minimum deviation condition. See, this is a rare condition. Next one, sorry. Now, maximum deviation. So maximum deviation ki angle of incidence allowed. Condition for maximum deviation. For maximum deviation, I should be 90. I 90 avalante, idi perpendicular, I 90 avalante, ila enter aval. So this is also called grazing incidence. So I 90 ne avantam, that is also called grazing incidence. Incidence allowed grazing through this surface. So this is called maximum deviation condition. I should be 90. If I equal to 90, then that is also called a grazing incidence or parallel to the surface incidence. So I 90 over. And so I 90, I say if you apply Snell's law, then here R1 equal to C. If you apply Snell's law, R1 equal to C. That is nothing but critical angle. So you can go through the critical angle concept in later classes. Now, what is A value? A equal to R1 plus R2. Na? What is the R1? C plus R2 equal to A. Now, from this equation, R2 can be written as R2 equal to A minus C. So, these are the main conditions for maximum deviation. Maximum deviation conditions are this one. So, maximum deviation means I should be, angle of incidence should be 90. Next, if I 90, then R1 equal to C. If R1 equal to C, then we can write A equal to R1 plus R2 or A equal to C plus R2 or R2 equal to A minus C. So these are the conditions for maximum deviation. Now, apply Snell's law at this surface or emerging surface. Apply Snell's law here. applies Snell's law at this surface, or that is nothing but a emerging surface. So according to Snell's law, so what is the angle here? R2. Refractive index mu. So mu into sine R2 equal to here refractive index 1. So 1 into sine E. What is the angle in this one? E. Refractive index into sine of the angle in that medium. That equal to refractive index into sine of the angle in other medium. Now from this one we can write sine E as mu into sine A minus E. Why? Because R2 is how much? A minus C na? Just substitute R2 here, then you will get this equation. Or rearrange this even for E. So take sine that side, then sine inverse of. Sine inverse of, you will get. So E can be written as. What is E? From this one, E equal to sine inverse of sine A minus C. Sine A minus C. Into mu also there. Into mu. Now what is the formula for mu? If you apply Snell's law at this surface, then sine 1 into sine 90 equal to mu into sine R1. So R1 equal to C sine 91. So mu sine C. Now from that one, mu can be written as 1 by sine C. So sine inverse into 1 by sine C into sine of A minus C is the formula for E. This is the formula for E. So if you apply Snell's law at this surface, then you will get this equation. Then if you substitute value of mu, then you will get this one. Now what is the deviation angle? Deviation angle is, what is the formula in terms of deviation angle? So I plus E equal to delta plus A. No? Now from this one, deviation angle can be written as delta equal to I plus E minus A. What is I value? 90 plus E value sine inverse into sine A minus C by sine C minus A. This is the formula for deviation angle. So these 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are the formulas for a maximum deviation. So these are last priority. So last priority, just remember this one. If you remember these conditions, you can write these equations easy. Next one. Condition for no emergence. Condition for no emergence. That means light ray enter into the prism. And that will refract it through the prism. After that, that is not coming out of the prism. That is reflecting in this prism only, within the prism only. That is also nothing but a total internal reflection. That means there is no light that is coming from the prism. The total light is going to reflect internally. That is called TIR, total internal reflection. Now, condition for total internal reflection or no emergence, both are same. Condition for no emergence or total internal reflection, both are same. Now, for a total internal reflection, R2 greater than critical angle C. R2 should be greater than critical angle C. Now, what is the formula for A? A equal to R1 plus R2 na? From first equation, prism equation. What is R1 na? That is greater than C plus R1. So, A should be greater than R1 plus C. What is the value of R2 from previous discussion? Greater than C na, plus greater than C. So, A is greater than R1 plus C. R1 plus C. Next, maximum value of the possible R1 is nothing but C only. R1 equal to maximum possibility is R1 should be equal to C. Next, maximum possibility R1 equal to C means A is greater than C plus C. Na? So A is greater than 2C. This is for a total internal reflection or no emergence condition. In the case of no emergence, R2 should be greater than C. A greater than R1 plus C or A greater than 2C. These are the condition for no emergence or total internal reflection. Next. When a light ray incident normally, next condition. When a light ray incident normally on a prism, then what happens? For example, this is a prism. This is a normal drawn to the surface. Here is the normal drawn to the surface. A light ray that is entering into the prism normally, that means a light ray also traveling in this direction, parallel to the normal. So angle of incidence is how much? Zero. If a light ray that is a incident perpendicular to the surface, then that is the incident angle is zero. If incident angle is zero, then R1 also zero. Because if you substitute this one, then sin I equal to mu into sin R1. Then if it is zero, then R1 also zero. Now, so in this case, the condition for no emergence is A should be greater than C. In this case, A should be greater than C because R1 is zero. Na? If R1 is zero means A equal to R1 plus R2, so R1 is 0 plus R2. If no emergence, R2 equal to C, na? So A equal to C or A should be greater than C. That is the condition for no emergence. Now, so if A equal to C, if you apply sin on both sides, then sin A should be greater than sin C. Or sin C, what is the formula for sin C? That is 1 by mu. Sin C formula is already we discussed in previous slide. That is 1 by mu. Or mu can be written as mu equal to 1 by sin A. 1 by sin A can be written as cosecant A. Mu is cosecant A. These are the formulas for incident light ray that is normal. What is the previous one? That is a no, that is a total internal reflection and no emergence. So these, so what is the main condition? Minimum, this is a maximum deviation. What is the important one? Minimum deviation is the important, most important one is a minimum deviation condition. Now check this one. What is the minimum deviation conditions? I equal to E, R1 equal to R2 equal to R. What is the other formulas? R equal to A by 2, I equal to A plus D by 2, mu equal to sin I by sin A by 2, or mu equal to sin A plus delta by 2 by sin A by 2. These are the formulas for a minimum deviation. These are very, very important in this prism topic. First priority is these minimum deviation formulas only. After that, maximum deviation. After that, so no emergence and total internal reflection. After that, ray that is incident perpendicular to the surface. So these are the conclusions. These are the formulas for prism. Okay, can I go through the problems? Now go through this problem first. First problem. So what is the given problem here? The critical angle between equilateral prism. Equilateral prism means so angle is 60. A equal to 60. Critical angle is 45 degrees. If the incident ray perpendicular to the refracting surface, that means how is the diagram? So how is the incident ray? That is perpendicular to refracting surface. This is the incident ray. So that means this is same as the last condition. Na? So what we discussed in last condition, this one only. So what is the value of I in this one? I equal to, what is the value of I? I equal to 0. R1 equal to 0. R2 equal to C. A is greater than C. So these are the conclusions. Now, so finalize which one is correct. It is after a deviation, it will emerge from the second surface. So it won't emerge. So it will reflect internally. Next, it is totally reflected on the second surface and emerges out perpendicular from the third surface in air. So let me check that one. Next, so it is totally reflected from the second and third refracting surface and finally emerges out from the first surface. Next, it is totally reflected from all the sides of the prism, never emerges out. So critical angle is given as a 45 degrees. Critical angle is given as a 45 degrees. When it enter into this one like this, then what happens? Check this right. When it enter into the prism like this, with a angle I equal to 0, then that is going to reflect at the bottom. Now, so here is 90 degrees. He said that angle of prism is 60. This is 90, this is 60. So it will be 30. Because total angle in a triangle is 180 degrees. If it is 30, then this one is 60. So here reflection is there. Angle of reflection is same as angle of incident. So this is also 60. So it is coming out like this. So now what is the conclusion? How you are going to select the best option? So check the options once. It is totally reflected on the second surface and emerges out perpendicular from the third surface. That is the correct option. So this is entering into the first surface and reflected at second surface and emerging out perpendicular to the third surface. So that is the conclusion from this diagram. Now, next one. So these are easy questions only. So no need to worry, just go through the formulas and try to solve. Now check this question once. A prism mu refractive index as 1.5 has a refracting angle 30 degrees. Now what is given data here? Refracting angle is given. Refracting angle is nothing but A. Mu is equal to 1.5. What is the other one? A equal to 30. Refracting angle. Now, the deviation of the monochromatic light ray incident normally on its surface will be So, incident normally on its surface. Now, I is how much? I equal to zero. So what is given? Prism mu equal to 1.5 has a refracting angle. Refracting angle. Take that one as R. R equal to 30. For first surface, R1 equal to 30. Mu is 1.5. I equal to 0. Now, so when a light ray enter perpendicular, so I equal to 0. Now, what we have to calculate? Deviation angle. Delta we have to calculate. Deviation angle. Now, apply Snell's law at first surface. Just go through this diagram once. Here is the diagram. So, this is the prism. Now, incident angle is perpendicular to first surface. So, I equal to 0. Perpendicular to surface means what is the angle between normal and light ray? 0 is the angle, not 90. Next, if I enter into the 90 degrees angle, R1 also 0. R1 is equal to 0. Now, so that traces that will travel in a straight line path. Now, here that makes an angle 30 degrees. Why? Because why it is making an angle 30 degrees? How you are finalizing that one? So, this is 0 means this is 90. Angle of prism is given as 30, 90 and 30. So it is how much? 60. If it is 60, here angle is 30. So here angle is how much? 30. Now apply Snell's law here and here. So this is of refractive index mu. So 1 by mu equal to sin 30 by sin E. 1 by mu equal to, if you apply Snell's law here, then you will get 1 by mu equal to sin 30 by E, or sin E equal to mu into sin 30. If you apply Snell's law at this surface, mu into sin 30 equal to sin E. So that only this equation. Next, substitute the values. sin e equal to, what is the value of mu? Mu value is how much? 1/5. What is the value of sin 30? 1/2. Now you will get 0.75. Sin e equal to 0.75, then e equal to 48 degrees. So that is already given in question. 48 degrees is nothing but 0.75. So that I am taking now. So e equal to 48.36. What we have to calculate? Deviation angle. Deviation angle formula. So delta equal to I plus E minus A. Na? This is the formula. What is the value of I? 0. E value is how much? 48. A value 30. 48.36 minus 30. So that is nothing but 80.36. Deviation angle. What is the basic formula? For prism, deviation always I plus E minus A only. That is the deviation angle. Minimum deviation angle means that is different. Next one. Go through this one. When a light ray are incident on prism at an angle 45 degrees, that means what is the given data there? I is how much? I equal to 45 degrees. Now, what is the other angle? Minimum deviation is observed. That means you have to use formulas that is related to the minimum deviation. Minimum deviation condition only you have to apply. Now, if the refractive index of the material of the prism is root 2. So, mu equal to root 2. Now, the angle of the prism is, angle of prism means A you have to calculate. So, this is the data. This is very simple, but question length is maybe so a large one is there. Question length is high, but solution is very small for this type of prism. Minimum deviation means that is very easy question. If they specify that that is the minimum deviation, that is very easy only. Is this clear? Now, so this is the given data. I is given as 45, mu is root 2, A is we have to calculate. Now, in minimum deviation condition, is there any relation with this? What is the formula for mu? Mu equal to sin I by sin R. Na? Value of mu, mu equal to sin I by sin R. So again, R formula. What is the formula for R in minimum deviation condition? R equal to A by 2. R equal to A by 2. Substitute that one here. Sin I by sin A by 2. Substitute the values in this equation, then you will get the answer. What is sin I? What is the mu value? Root 2 is equal to sin I is 45 degrees by sin A by 2. Root 2 value is how much? Cross multiply this one. Sin A by 2 equal to sin 45 by root 2. Sin 45 is 1 by root 2, na? So that you will get 1 by 2. Sin A by 2 is 1 by 2 means A equal to how much? A by 2 equal to 30 degrees. So A equal to 60 degrees. Like this you have to answer. Just only one formula. Just I am using formula that we discussed in minimum deviation condition. We discussed this formula in minimum deviation condition. Just direct the substitution only. No need to worry about that prism concept. So prism concept is a very easy one in this case, in this lesson. Now, so that is the answer, A equal to 60. Now go through this one. Angle of minimum deviation for a prism of refractive index 1.5 is equal to angle of the prism. So what is the given data there? Minimum deviation condition only. So here what is mu? Refractive index mu is given as 1.5. Next, what is the other quantity given? Mu is given as 1.5. Next. Minimum deviation for a prism of refractive index 1.5 is equal to angle of the prism. So which one we have to equate? Minimum deviation is equal to angle of the prism. So deviation angle is equal to angle of the prism we have to do. Now then angle of the prism is, you have to calculate angle of the prism. What is the formula? Mu equal to sine of a plus delta by 2 by sine a by 2. This is the formula for minimum deviation. Just to substitute these values here, then you will get the answer. Direct substitution. So what you have to calculate? Either a or delta. Either one you have to calculate. Substitute a instead of delta here. Then mu is 1.5, na? So 1.5 equal to. So what is the value of a and delta are same. So either one you have to calculate. So sine of a plus a, delta is same as a, na? A plus a is how much? 2a. 2a by 2 means a only. Sine a by sine a by 2. Now just expand this one. This is like a sine 2 theta formula you have to use. Sine 2 theta formula is a 2 sine theta cos theta. Sine 2 theta formula is a 2 sine theta cos theta. So if sine theta is there, then instead of sine 2 theta, if sine theta is there, then formula is a sine theta formula is a 2 sine theta by 2 cos theta by 2. You can write like this. By this is the basic formula, sine 2 theta formula, 2 sine theta cos theta. Use that one and rewrite the equation for sine theta, then you will get a 2 sine theta by 2 into cos theta by 2. So apply this concept, 2 sine a by 2 into cos a by 2 by sine a by 2. Now you can cancel the sine a by 2 and sine a by 2. You can cancel a sine a by 2 and a by 2. Then how much you will get? Cancel these two. Then 1.5 equal to 2 into cos a by 2. Now cos a by 2 is equal to 0.75. Now so what is the value of 0.75? 41 degrees. So a by 2 equal to 41. Then a equal to 82. Then a equal to 82. Just a direct substitution only. So this is the formula. Substitute the value directly, but you have to use this expansion. A by 2 is 41 means a is how much? 82. A by 2 is 41. So that a is 82. Now go through the next problem. Next one. Go through this one. The refractive index of a prism for a monochromatic wave is a root 2. That means the refractive index is given. So refractive index means mu is given as root 2. Now its refracting angle is 60. Refracting angle is 60. That means a equal to 60. The minimum deviation, then angle of, for minimum deviation, angle of incidence is. So what you have to calculate? I we have to calculate. Now what is the formula that relates these three quantities in minimum deviation condition? Mu equal to sin I by sin A by 2. Na? This formula is there or not? Minimum deviation condition. In minimum deviation condition, this formula is there or not? Yes, it is there. We discussed this one also. Substitute these values here, then you will get the answer. Root 2 equal to sin I by sin 60 by 2, sin 30. Now from this one, if you rearrange this one, then you will get sin I equal to root 2 into sin 30. Sin 30 is 1 by 2. So root 2 by 2, that equal to 1 by root 2. This is a sin I. Sin I equal to 1 by root 2. Then I is how much? If sin I equal to 1 by root 2, then I equal to 45 degrees. So option B is the correct one. This is also direct substitution only. Minimum deviation means this is one of the formula in minimum deviation condition. direct substitution only. There is no deviations. Next one. So this one related to next topic. I'll go through the next one. Now, go through this one once. A light ray incident by grazing one of the face. Grazing means that is passing through the face. Now, I is how much in that case? Grazing incidents. Grazing incidents means light ray need to travel like this. That is called grazing. Grazing at one surface. So I is how much? I equal to 90 degrees. Now, after that, the refraction of the ray and does not emerge out. So that means this is not coming out. This is a reflection in within the prism. Total internal reflection. Now we are getting there. Now, for this one, what is the angle of prism? What is the relation between angle of prism and critical angle? What is the relation between critical angle and angle of prism? So what is the relation? We discussed it or not? For this diagram, grazing incidents. What is the relation between A and C? So let me check that one. Just go through these previous slides and previous formula slides and check it once. Now, so this is the diagram. Same. So what is the condition here? What is the relation between grazing incidents and total internal reflection? So here, what is the condition we got? A is greater than condition for no emergence and total internal reflection. A should be greater than 2C. A should be greater than 2C. Now, what is the answer for that? A should be greater than 2C. Total internal reflection means A should be greater than 2C. Next. So try to solve this one. A parallel beam of monochromatic light incident at one surface of equilateral prism. Equilateral prism means A value is 60. Next. Angle of incidence is 55. I equal to 55. Next. Angle of emergence is 46. E equal to 46. Now, angle of minimum deviation, that is delta, is how much? Angle of minimum deviation is how much? So, deviation angle formula, deviation angle is I plus E minus A. Deviation angle, that is the formula for deviation angle. So, that one we discussed in the first case of prism. Prism first case lo discuss something. Direct substitute cheyadame. I am the 55, E and the 46, 55 plus 46 minus 60. So 55 plus 46, 101 minus 60, that is 41. So deviation angle and 41. So deviation angle and 41. He is asking about minimum deviation. Minimum. So 41 can takku untada 41 can ekku untada. So less than 41, that is equal to 41, more than 41, none of the. So minimum deviation angle. So deviation angle 41 vachindi. Minimum undalante dingan takku undali ekku undali. So minimum deviation angle. Minimum deviation angle. Always less than deviation angle only. Always less than deviation angle. So option A is correct. Always less than a deviation angle. So option A correct. Next, go through this one. Light rays from a source are incident on a glass prism of refractive index mu. Angle of the prism is alpha. So what is given? Angle of the prism here, A equal to alpha given. So mu value is mu. Now, angle of deviation of the emergent rays. So he is asking about angle of deviation for a thin prism. So here angle of deviation formula mu minus 1 into A. What is the value of A? Is alpha. So angle of deviation is mu minus 1 into alpha. Direct formula substitution. This is the formula. For thin prism, deviation angle is mu minus 1 into A. No? Already we discussed it. So by using that one, you will get this answer. So which option is the correct one? Second option is the correct one. Mu minus 1 into alpha. Next. Next question. The angle of minimum deviation for a prism is 40 degrees. So what is given? Delta is given as 40. Next, the angle of prism is 60. A equal to 60 degrees. A equal to 60 degrees. Then angle of incidence, I equal to. I is how much? So minimum deviation is given. So what is the relation between minimum deviation, A and I? So I equal to, so A plus deviation by 2 na, for minimum deviation condition. Minimum deviation condition, this also one formula we discussed already. Substitute the values. A value is 60, delta is 40 by 2, 100 by 2. That is nothing but 50 degrees. 50 degrees is the answer. Next one. Go through the next one. Deviation of 5 degrees is observed for a prism whose angle is small, whose refractive index is 1.5, then angle of prism is. So deviation is observed. So what is given there? Deviation angle is given as 5. So deviation equal to 5 degrees. Next, refractive index mu is 1.5. What we have to calculate? A. What is the relation between these three quantities for a small angle prism? Small angle prism. Small angle prism, delta equal to mu minus 1 into A. So mu value is how much? 1.5 minus 1 into A equal to delta is how much? 5 degrees. So 5 degrees, 5 equal to 0.5 into A. So A equal to 10 degrees. Direct substitution. What is the formula used? This one only. That is for small angle prism, that is valid. Delta deviation angle is mu minus 1 into A. That is for small angle prism. Next. Go through the next one. So this is related to next topic, dispersion. Now, go through the next problem. Angle of minimum deviation measured with the prism is 30 degrees. The angle of prism is 60. Then refractive index of the material. Check it once. What is the given data here? The angle of minimum deviation is 30. So delta equal to 30 degrees. What is the other quantity? Angle of prism is 60. So A equal to 60 degrees given. A is given as a 60. Next one, refractive index of the prism. So you have to calculate a mu value. Now, what is the formula for mu? For minimum deviation, mu equal to sin of A plus delta by 2 by sin A by 2. Just direct substitute and solve. So in the substitute anyway, sin of A value and the 60, delta value and the 30. So 60 plus 30 by 2 by sin A by 2, 60 by 2, sin A by 2, that is nothing but 60 by 2. Then, so how much it is? Sin 90 by 2, sin 45, sin 45 by sin 30. 45 is 1 by root 2. So 30 is 1 by 2. So root 2 by 2 by root 2. Now, how much it is? 2 by root 2 is nothing but root. So what is the correct answer? Option A. Next question. The minimum deviation produced by hollow prism filled with a certain liquid is found to be 30 degrees. A light ray is also found to be refracted at an angle 30 degrees. Then refractive index of the liquid. Minimum deviation angle is how much? What is the minimum deviation angle? Delta equal to 30 degrees. Now the light ray is also found to be refracted at an angle of 30 degrees. So angle of refraction is also 30. Now we need to calculate refractive index. Same formula as previous one. Same formula as previous one. Go through this. So refraction angle R is going, not A. This is R. What is the formula for mu sin of A plus delta by 2 by sin A by 2? Now for minimum deviation, A equal to 2R. So A equal to 2 into 30, that equal to 60. Substitute and solve in this equation, then you will get the answer. Direct substitution only. Directly substitute it. No, directly value substitute change the A value delta value. Delta value 30, so A value 60. So and that's the value. Same. The Monday on the other also. 30, 60 and same in the Monday on the formula. Root to nails. Next. Minimum deviation is observed with a prism having an angle of prism A and angle of deviation delta, angle of incidence I, angle of emergence E. Then what is the best relation in this one? So we will exact relation in minimum deviation. Minimum deviation of all and a condition in this one, I equal to E is the one condition. One of the condition for minimum deviation is I equal to E. Now what is the correct answer? Which one you are going to select? Option E is the correct one. Option E is the correct one. I equal to E condition, R1 equal to R2 condition. Technically then select this coach. Next, try to solve this one. So angle of prism is 30. So angle of prism is 30 means A is given as 30. Next, refractive index is root 2. Mu equal to root 2 and one of the surface is silvered at want angle of incidence, ray should be incident on one surface so that after reflection from the silvered surface, it retraces its path. So you have to calculate I value. Angle of incidence we have to calculate. So what is the diagram for this one? Check this one. So that is incident on one surface. After that, that refracted through this one. After that, that reflected back and retraces its path. Retraces means adhe patra malli ankara. Idanta silver jason. Silver jason ante that is nothing but like a mirror. Silvered ante so that acts as a mirror. Mirror kinda act chestu. Mirror kinda act chesthe emaindi malli retraces its path antunnadante. అదే ఏ పాత్ర వెళ్ళిందో మళ్ళీ అదే పాత్ర బ్యాక్ వచ్చింది. సో అప్లై స్నెల్స్ లా హియర్ వాట్ ఈస్ గివెన్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఫార్ములా ఏ ఈక్వల్ టు ఆర్ వన్ ప్లస్ ఆర్ టూ ఆర్ వన్ ప్లస్ ఆర్ టూ ఆర్ వన్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఆర్ ఆర్ టూ మళ్ళీ రిఫ్లెక్ట్ అయిపోయింది కాబట్టి జీరో సో ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ టు 30 ఏ 30 ఇచ్చాడు చూడండి వాట్ ఈస్ ద క్వశ్చన్ ఏ ఈస్ గివెన్ యాజ్ 30 సో ఏ ఈక్వల్ టు ఆర్ కదా సో దట్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ టు 30 సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ దట్ వాల్యూ ఇన్ దిస్ ఈక్వేషన్ So what is the formula for mu? Sin I by sin R. If you apply Snell's law for this surface, mu equal to sin I by sin R. What is the value of mu? Root 2 equal to sin I by sin 30. Then sin 30 need to scale there. Root 2 by root 2 into 1 by 2 equal to sin I. So this is 1 by root 2 equal to sin I. Sin I equal to 1 by root 2 means I equal to 45. Retraces its path means R2 equal to 0. R2 equal to 0. R1 is how much? R. Use the basic relation. So he didn't mention any minimum deviation. Na? Minimum deviation and yavala gada. Minimum deviation yavala gada. So basic prism formulas order. Mu equal to apply Snell's law here. Then you will get this equation and substitute and solve. Next one. Go through this diagram. The figure represents three cases of ray passing through a prism of an angle A. The case corresponding to minimum deviation is. The case corresponding to minimum deviation is. సో ఈ మూడింటిలో మినిమం డీవియేషన్ కండిషన్ అన్నది ఏది ఎలా చెప్పగలరు? సో హియర్ థర్డ్ డయాగ్రామ్ ఈస్ ద మినిమం డీవియేషన్ కండిషన్. దిస్ వన్ ఈస్ ఫర్ మినిమం డీవియేషన్. ఇన్ మినిమం డీవియేషన్ రిఫ్రాక్టెడ్ రే షుడ్ బి ప్యారలల్ టు ద బేస్ ఆఫ్ ది ప్రిజమ్. బేస్ ఆఫ్ ది ప్రిజమ్ కి రిఫ్రాక్టెడ్ రే ఎలా ఉండాలి? ప్యారలల్ గా ఉండాలి. సో థర్డ్ డయాగ్రామ్ ఈస్ ద రిప్రజెంట్స్ ద మినిమం డీవియేషన్ కండిషన్. Next one. Go through this one. A ray of light passes through equilateral glass prism. Equilateral means A should be equal to 60. A equal to 60. Such that the angle of incidence is equal to angle of emergence. I equal to E. He gave that angle of incidence equal to angle of emergence. And each of the angle is equal to 3 by 4 of the angle of prism. This is equal to 3 by 4 of angle of prism. So I equal to E equal to 3 by 4 into 60. So how much it is? 45 degrees. I equal to E equal to 45. A is 60, now just substitute that one. So we got these values. Now what we need to calculate? Angle of deviation. So angle of deviation formula, I plus E minus A. What is the I value? E value 45 plus 45 minus 60, 90 minus 60, that is a 30 degrees. Base substitution, basic prism formula, basic prism, not a minimum deviation. Ekkada minimum deviation ani specify cheyala. మినిమం డీవియేషన్ స్పెసిఫై చేయకపోతే బేసిక్ కండిషన్కి వెళ్ళిపోవాలి. సో ఫార్ములాస్, సో బేసిక్ ఏమున్నాయి చూడండి, తర్వాత మినిమం డీవియేషన్ కండిషన్ ఏమున్నాయి. సారీ అండి, ఇంపార్టెంట్ మెయిన్ కండిషన్స్ ఇక్కడ. సో ఇవి బేసిక్, ఇవి అంటే మినిమం డీవియేషన్ ఇవ్వకపోతే వీటిలో ఏ ఫార్ములా అయినా వాడచ్చు, వీటిలో ఏ ఫార్ములా అయినా వాడచ్చు. సో 1, 2, 3, 4 ఈ నాలుగు ఫార్ములాస్లో ఏదైనా వాడచ్చు. మినిమం డీవియేషన్ అని ఇవ్వకపోతే, మినిమం డీవియేషన్ ఇస్తే ఈ ఫార్ములాస్ వాడాలి. ఐ ఈక్వల్ టు ఈ, ఆర్ వన్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఆర్ టూ ఈక్వల్ టు ఆర్, అదర్ ఫార్ములాస్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఏ బై టూ, ఐ ఈక్వల్ టు ఏ ప్లస్ డి బై టూ, ఆర్ మ్యూ ఈక్వల్ టు సైన్ ఏ బై సైన్ ఏ బై టూ, మ్యూ ఈక్వల్ టు సైన్ ఏ ప్లస్ డెల్టా బై టూ బై సైన్ ఏ బై టూ. సో ఇవి ఈ నాలుగు ప్లస్ ఈ రెండు, దీనికి మినిమం డీవియేషన్ కండిషన్ అంటేనే ఇవి వాడాలి. మినిమం డీవియేషన్ కండిషన్ అనుకుంటే నార్మల్ కంటే ఈ నాలుగు ఫార్ములాస్లో ఏదైనా వాడాలి. సో అలా కాకుండా థిన్ ప్రిజం అంటే డెల్టా, ఇది ఒకటే ఫార్ములా. థిన్ ప్రిజమ్ డీవియేషన్ యాంగిల్ థిన్ ప్రిజం అంటే మ్యూ మైనస్ వన్ ఇంటూ ఏ. దిస్ ఇస్ ఫర్ థిన్ ప్రిజం. సో మ్యాక్సిమం డీవియేషన్, సో ఇంకా మిగిలిన కండిషన్స్ ఒకసారి చూసాం కదా. సో మెయిన్ ఏంటంటే ఇదే మినిమం డీవియేషన్ కండిషన్. సో బేసిక్ ఈక్వేషన్స్ ఇవి. నెక్స్ట్ మినిమం డీవియేషన్ కండిషన్స్ ఇవి. సో ఈ దీస్ ఫోర్ ప్లస్ దిస్ వన్ అండ్ దిస్ వన్ ఆర్ కన్సండర్ మినిమం డివియేషన్. జస్ట్ మినిమం డివియేషన్ లో ఫార్ములాస్ ఏంటి, ఆ సిక్స్ ఫార్ములాస్ రాయండి. నార్మల్ గా ఉంటే ఫార్ములాస్ ఏంటి, ఈ ఫోర్ ఫార్ములాస్. నెక్స్ట్ థిన్ ప్రిజం కి అయితే ఒకటే ఫార్ములా ఉంది, ఒకటే ఫార్ములా. సో ఇవి మేజర్. సో ఇవి గుర్తుంటే మాక్సిమం ప్రాబ్లమ్ సాల్వ్ అయిపోతాయి. సో ఇవి అయిపోయిన తర్వాత ఏం చేస్తారు, సో మాక్సిమం డివియేషన్ కి వెళ్ళాలి. ఇవన్నీ కంప్లీట్ అయిన తర్వాత మాక్సిమం డివియేషన్ కండిషన్స్ ఏంటి. సో మాక్సిమం డివియేషన్ అంటే యాంగిల్ ఎంత ఉంటుంది చూడండి. నెక్స్ట్ టోటల్ ఇంటర్నల్ రిఫ్లెక్షన్, ఇంటర్నల్ రిఫ్లెక్షన్ కి ఎలా ఉంటాయి కండిషన్స్. ఇలా సెపరేట్ గా 1 by 1 వర్కౌట్ చేస్తే, సో దిస్ ఈస్ వెరీ ఈజీ టాపిక్. సో యూ కెన్ గెట్ మార్క్స్ ఇన్ జేఈఆర్ నీట్ వెరీ ఈజీలీ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ టాపిక్. సో మినిమం డీవియేషన్ కండిషన్ మీదే ఎక్కువ సార్లు అడిగింది కూడా లేదు. అది మిస్ అయితే జస్ట్ ప్రిజం ఫస్ట్ ఫోర్ ఫార్ములాస్ ఉన్నాయి కదా అది. సో మాక్సిమం డీవియేషన్ కానీ లేదు గ్రేజింగ్ యాంగిల్ కానీ, సో అవి రేర్ కండిషన్స్ అన్నమాట. అంటే తక్కువ సార్లు అడిగారు. సో ప్రియారిటీ తీసుకుంటే ఇది తక్కువ ప్రియారిటీ, సెకండ్ ప్రియారిటీ.